Hey everyone, I'm Carolyn, and welcome back to another episode of As I See It. If you clicked on this video because you saw my face, just be warned, this is not my RV life channel. This is my political channel. Even though I am in my RV, traveling cross country, I talk politics too. And, you know, for those of you who are like, why would I want to listen to a politics from an RV homeless person? I actually have a degree from UC Berkeley in political science and economics, and I am very plugged in. I still continue to learn and study politics. So, you know, and I'm just a concerned citizen. So take that. Take that. I need to talk today about mainstream media. This is something I've been wanting to talk about for a while, but I'm just traveling along, cruising along, and NPR is talking about tonight's debate. And they said 70% of Americans are going to watch tonight's debate. Great. Trump has a little bit of a lead. He has a little bit of an edge because voters say that he, because voters believe, I can't remember what they said, what word they used, that voters believe that he has a better handle on the economy, that he's better on the border, that he's better on international relations and what's going on in the Middle East, that he's better on foreign policy. Harris, on the other hand, is a little more likable. I mean, are you freaking kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me? I am so tired of mainstream media treating Trump like he is a normal freaking candidate. Stop it. Stop it. When you talk about him, you need to mention that the debate tonight is between two candidates. One is a 34-time convicted felon who was already president and refused to leave office and, in fact, incited a mob to storm the Capitol. And he threatened to hang his vice president while he sat there and did nothing. This guy who is saying he is going to be a dictator on day one, the guy who is saying he is going to suspend the Constitution, the guy who is saying he is going to put anybody who supports Kamala Harris in jail. That's what he's saying. And look it up. That's what he is saying. From what I understand, he is even saying he's going to find anybody who donates to Kamala Harris. He's trying to scare us. But anybody who supports Kamala Harris, anybody who is against him, he is going to throw in jail. That is how you need to introduce him. That is how you need to talk about him, mainstream media. This is bullshit. I am so tired of mainstream media trying to... What are you doing? This isn't fair and balanced. This is enabling a fascist. This, you are enabling him. You got him elected in 2016. You made the race too close in 2016, and you're freaking doing it again. You are enabling a dictator. Stop it. They are not the same. Americans need to know, those who aren't as plugged in, those who are undecided, or those who are in the middle and still not sure, they need to know they are not the same. One candidate wants to preserve democracy. The other candidate wants to rip up the Constitution, continue to stack government with his loyalists, just like he stacked the Supreme Court, who took away rights for the first time in American history. We have a Supreme Court who actually took away rights from women. They are not the same. Trump is freaking dangerous. Everything we know about our country and about America and what it means to be American is at stake. All the freedoms that you say you love and want will be gone, guaranteed, under Trump. Guaranteed. Stop pretending they're the same. Mainstream media, the blood will be on your hands. That's how I see it. Let me know how you guys see it. Leave your thoughts and comments below.